guys again. So DIY, because I did miss the Saturday video as well as the Tuesday video. I know, I'm horrible. This week's been kind of stressful. We've been getting everything ready and we moved Rihanna up to Ball State. So it's been kind of chaotic, but without further ado, let's get into our chalkboard DIY notebook. Alright, so if you haven't already noticed, we are going to do a DIY chalkboard notebook. So just a few supplies that you'll need a notebook, but you can pick this up at Target. I picked it up for 50 cents in the back to school section. You'll also need chalkboard markers. These are not permanent. You have to watch which ones you get because some of them will say permanent, but I picked these up at Walmart. You'll also need some chalkboard paint. This is Craft Smart. I picked this up at Michael's. I think it was about $1.49. You can also use any type of paintbrush, but I also have some glitter glue and some glitter stars. Just put it in at the top cover so you don't get paint on your notebook pages. Just like that. And it will take multiple layers because this is a cheaper type of chalkboard paint. Alright, so as I am finishing up the first coat, I have found a technique that makes this a lot easier in painting. Okay, so if you just add like a little drop of paint on like a single row, it's like you make individual rows, and you just go once and like backwards and you just keep going it in. Because of these composition notebooks, it's like a marbled effect with like white. So you want to make sure that doesn't show through. And like up here you can see it more, but down here like I started to find the technique. Guys, so I did just finish the last coat and it actually looks pretty good. I just put some paint on the black part, the black strip here, just so that way we could write on it if we wanted to. Have removed the paper from the inside. As you can see, there's some chalkboard paint around the edges, which we prevented from getting onto our notebook paper. That is why we used that piece of paper. But I'm just gonna show you with my chalkboard pen before we decorated it or all, that it actually dried, the second coat dried actually really quick. So as you can see, I'm touching it and but nothing is coming off. This is what it used to look like, and that's what it is now. So these pens I had purchased from Walmart, as if you can tell. Yeah. So these pens, they tell you to shake them really well before you use them. So then once you shake it, you just remove the cap, and then before you use it, you're gonna want to push down on the tip so that all the writing comes down to the bottom. So just hold it there. And if you, like, pump it, it might, like, bring more to it. But let's just show you here. As you can see, it did write, and it will remove. If you just take a wet piece of paper towel and just take it off, that'll work. Or if you have any handy eyeglass cleaner, like if you have glasses and you have eyeglass cleaner sitting around, that will also remove it very well. Alright, so I just had sprayed some eyeglass cleaner on a napkin and then I just removed it, and some of the paint will come off when you go to remove it. If you can see there how it's dark, It will not remove a lot, but it some of it will come off. But it still looks good. So, as you can see, it comes right off. But you have to make sure that you do not get the permanent chalk markers. They do sell them, and you have to actually read that you're getting the right one. So definitely get this brand. It is Hampton Art Chalk Marker. That's my glitter glue here. I also have these glitter stars, as well as these glitter letters. So I have fixed the lettering a few times because it has bugged me. I really wanted the more of the calligraphy writing, but I don't have that nice of writing. I have good writing, but it could always be better. So as you guys can see, my chalkboard notebook is done. I did make this one specialized for chemistry because in that class we take a lot of notes, so I figured it would be a good idea. I've been fixing the lettering a lot, but I also added some glitter glue to it. I have chemistry, and then over here I wrote notes, and then I have the YouTube play button. And my YouTube channel, and I post videos every Saturday, and subscribe. If you guys like this video, please give it a big thumbs up, and if you're not already, hit that red subscribe button down below. You guys can follow me on Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter, and Facebook. You guys can tweet me new video suggestions. I will post videos every Saturday and try on Tuesdays. If you guys like this DIY and would like to see some more DIYs, comment down below what you would like to see. Thank you guys so much for watching and have a wonderful day.